Hey guys, it's Corey with 10 Best Ones. And today we've decided to review the 5 best options for you. If you'd like to see their price and find out more information, you can check out the links in the description down below. Let's get started. We are going to start this list with the best budget option that you can get your hands on.
Number 5, HP Envy Desktop TE010020. The Envy TE010020 desktop computer from HP is built to fuel your creativity, allowing you to render, edit, stream, and broadcast video content. It also delivers a quality entertainment and surround sound for more immersive media experiences. This system is powered by a 3GHz Intel Core i7-9700 8-core processor. If you need more power, the CPU can be overclocked, 4.7GHz, and the 16GB of 2 666MHz DDR4 RAM, which is expandable to 32GB, allows the computer to quickly access frequently used files and programs. The Nightfall Black chassis has rounded corners and a ribbed front, which gives off a vague Sydney Opera House aesthetic if the Opera House were rectangular. You should still probably hide this PC beneath your desk if possible, but if the front shows, at least it won't look boring. The version of the Envy desktop reviewed here includes a 6-core Intel Core i5 processor with Intel UHD 630 integrated graphics, 12GB of DDR4 2666 memory, and a 512GB SSD. Other configuration options include an 8-core Core i7 CPU, NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1660 graphics, and up to 16GB of memory. The Envy TE010020 comes with extensive connectivity options, as it supports one USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-C port, 4 USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports. There's also a Super Multi-DVD burner and a 3-in-1 SD-SDHC-SDXC memory card reader. Once your PC is configured, you can connect to the internet wirelessly with dual band 2.4 and 5 GHz, Wi-Fi 5 or 802.11ac, or via the integrated gigabit Ethernet port. Additional wireless peripherals can be connected with Bluetooth 5.0. The Envy has a 180-watt internal power supply and includes a wireless keyboard, a wireless mouse, and a power cord. The installed operating system is Windows 10 Home 64-bit, and protection is provided by a limited 1-year warranty.
Next up, we have a model which gives you the best value for your money.
Number 4. CyberPower PC Supreme Liquid Cool. The more powerful the graphics card, the higher smoother frame rates you'll get, the higher resolution you can run at, and the better games will look. For graphics, this CyberPower PC computer has an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2070. We rate this NVIDIA GPU as powerful enough to run 996 games at a recommended level. With these combined, you'll be able to easily handle everyday tasks and even play graphically demanding games. To enhance this system's performance even further, you can install additional RAM modules for a max capacity of 64GB. For storage, it's equipped with a 500GB NVMe PCIe M.2 SSD, paired with a 2TB 7200 RPM HDD. Should you need more space, you can install additional storage drives or connect external storage solutions using its multiple USB ports. Other integrated features include 802.11ac Wi-Fi, a gigabit Ethernet port, HDMI and DisplayPort outputs, as well as audio in and out jacks. The operating system installed is Windows 10 Home, and it comes with a USB gaming keyboard and mouse, so you can get started as soon as possible. This system is built with Inner CyberPower PC Aluna 242V mid-tower case and has an 800-watt power supply. Moreover, it features a tempered glass side panel, custom RGB lighting, and liquid cooling. If you're going to play online multiplayer games, you'll need a faster internet connection. This CyberPower desktop computer offers 802.11ac Wi-Fi as well as a gigabit Ethernet RJ45 LAN jack, so you'll be able to have fast, wired or wireless internet access. If you want a pretty decent video editing computer that comes at a very reasonable price, you should definitely check out the CyberPower PC Supreme Liquid Cool.
Next up, we had the highest end model that you can get your hands on. It costs more than the rest, but it does do its job extremely well.
Number 3, Apple iMac Pro. One of the best video editing computers on the market today is the Apple iMac Pro. This one is the most powerful Mac ever, with an amazing performance, great design, superb cooling, and many more great features that'll make you take a look at this one. The Apple iMac Pro is the perfect desktop for many professionals and other people that want it for fun, but you should know that it's an expensive device. It has a pretty nice design and it looks very premium. It looks nearly the same as its predecessors with minor new features. It also has a nice space grey paint job that looks great and makes this desktop even more premium. I should also mention that the overall build quality of this all-in-one desktop is just amazing, and I can say that it can last you for many years. Apple iMac Pro has a lot of options when it comes to connectivity, including 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports, 4 USB 3.0 ports, a headphone jack, a 10 gigabit Ethernet port, and an SDXE card slot to complete the package. The best thing about this desktop is the 27-inch in-plane switch display with an astonishing 5K resolution of 5120 by 2880 pixels. When it comes to performance, I can say that this beast can do a great job with its Intel Xeon W2150B with 20 processing threads, 32GB of RAM that can be configurable up to 128GB, and 1TB of SSD. These specs make the Apple iMac Pro the most powerful all-in-one desktop without a doubt. I should also mention that this desktop has a Radeon Vega Pro 56 graphics unit with 8GB of HBM2 memory, making it great for heavy tasks such as real-time 3D rendering and VR work. You can't go wrong with this one, and I'm sure it does not disappoint. If you want one of the best, you should check out the iMac Pro.
Before we talk about the best model overall, let's look at the runner-up for this list.
Number 2. Corsair One i164. How much performance can be had out of a super small PC? If we base our opinions on Corsair's One i164, the answer is a simple, a lot. Coming in at 15 inches tall, this PC bundles not just Intel's 8-core i9-9900K inside, but also Nvidia's top-end GeForce RTX 2080 Ti. It's nice to see that this cylinder-style compact PC design has caught on, because it's great to be able to have a desktop that's small and quiet enough to sit on a desk instead of under it. Another key ingredient would be the performance, and this i164 model sure has it. The CPU under the hood is Intel's 8-core Core i9-9900K, while the GPU is Nvidia's top-end GeForce RTX 2080 Ti. Likewise, for both the CPU and GPU, there's plenty of memory for the high-end creator or gamer. The front I/O consists of 2x USB 3.1 Gen 1, a combo headphone mic, and a single HDMI 2.0 A port. The highlight of this is the front HDMI port, which Corsair market as VR-ready on the system itself. This is placed in a perfect position for VR headsets and will allow you to easily swap between VR and normal monitors when used with a USB port and 3.5mm jack on the front of the case. Could there have been a case that in 2020 SFF chassis start adopting USB Type-C as standard? We think so. A light pipe can be found on both sides of the front, and by default our sample came with a solid blue colour, not the blue-green scheme seen in a lot of marketing. The IQ software is where you configure this and other Corsair-specific lighting in your rig. If you're interested in a pre-built ITX system and don't mind the obvious caveats that come with it, Corsair's One is an excellent choice. It takes up very little space and delivers high-end performance with the most modest of noise levels.
Finally, the next model is the best overall. From us, it gets a perfect score in all categories.
Number 1. Alienware Aurora R11. The Aurora R11 is extremely customizable, and you can choose exactly the components you want. You can select either a 10th generation Core i5, i7 or i9 processor, and for graphics you can get the Nvidia GeForce GTX 1650 Super if you go for the base model, or go all the way up to 2 Nvidia GeForce RTX 2080 Ti cards in the highest tier model. In some of the lower tier models you can opt for an AMD card. In the second tier, you can swap out AMD Radeon RX 5700, an 8GB GDDR6 graphics card, for the Nvidia GeForce RTX 2060, 6GB GDDR6 at no additional cost. While some gaming PC towers boast bold designs with transparent glass, RGB fans, and enough colours to make you feel like you're at a rave, the Aurora R11 takes a much different design approach. The R11 is an unassuming, not too flashy and not too loud one. It's elegant and simple in appearance, with subtle strips of lighting on the front trim of the oblong chassis. This looks like a computer for someone with refined taste, as opposed to a colourful spectacle. Boot times are fast, and it jumps around different applications at lightning speed. Performance-wise, the Alienware Auroras are fantastic gaming desktops that offer the very latest components from AMD and Intel. Subsequently, you'll be getting decent performance for any of these desktops in accordance to their respective budget ranges. While once upon a time it was more cost-effective to simply buy each component separately and assemble your gaming PC by yourself, nowadays that value gap has significantly narrowed. The Aurora R11 could replace its predecessor as the best gaming desktop of the year. However, I should also mention that this computer is one of the best video editing computers in the market. Buying guide. Firstly, CPU. The CPU, or Central Processing Unit, is responsible for all the computing. Essentially, it's the brains of the operation, and it's one of the core components for a fast, reliable video editing PC. Video editing software relies heavily on the CPU. GPUs, however, are increasingly becoming more important for video encoding, so you'll want something fast, powerful, and capable of handling lots of things at once. The CPU industry is a duopoly, with the two reigning companies being Intel and AMD. Intel has a more significant share of the market, but AMD has steadily been gaining on its competitor in recent years. Video editors tend to stick with Intel because it's a reliable brand with solid products, and benchmarks show that it does a great job of handling single-core workloads. Secondly, GPU. The frequency of the GPU and the frequency of the GPU's video RAM, or VRAM, as well as VRAM capacity, are all important units of measurement that you should inspect before purchasing. GPU frequency is much like CPU frequency, which measures how many cycles are happening per second. Higher GPU frequencies mean you can render video faster, since the cores within the GPU are working at a faster pace. A GPU's VRAM holds the instructions that the GPU needs to execute. Having more VRAM is always better, since it can hold more instructions, which prevents bottlenecking the GPU. The frequency of the VRAM dictates how often it's syncing and passing off instructions to the GPU. And lastly, RAM. If you're a veteran video editor, you know the importance of RAM. The amount of available RAM dictates how fast videos load as you're scrubbing the timeline. Every cut, effect, and transition requires RAM, and more RAM means you can quickly load and view your video without waiting. Trying to edit video on a computer with just 4 or 8 gigabytes of RAM is an exercise in frustration, with tons of crashes, slow scrubbing, freezes, and dropped frames. While it's possible to go even higher, 64 gigabytes of RAM is more than enough for 1080p and 4K video editing, and it's just enough for 8K video editing. Special effects software such as After Effects also benefit from more RAM, and 64 gigabytes should be a sweet spot, but that may also depend on the available VRAM on the GPU. Adobe recommends up to 128 gigabytes of RAM, but that can cost well over $500. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.